Hello everyone, I'm Ken Wong, and welcome back to Perspective Plus, where I speak to visionary leaders who are pushing boundaries and shaping what is next in business. Today, I'm in Singapore, a place which runs on speed, structure, and logistics. And you know what? Only a few people understand that better than today's guests, Mr. Logan Nathan, CEO of ST Logistics. Logan has led digital transformation across one of the region's most critical logistic networks, serving sectors from defense and aviation to healthcare and public services. He is also someone who doesn't just talk about transformation, but he lives and breathes it. From building AI-powered operations to creating a culture that is ready to innovate and perform, Logan's is all about leading by example. Hey, Logan, thank you for joining me today.
Thanks for having me, Ken.
Well, it's great to have you here. So let me jump right in. While ST Logistics has been at the forefront of embracing AI and automation, from predictive analysis to streamlining operation and boosting efficiency, and this kind of technology adoption is transforming the logistic industry at a very, very rapid pace. So how exactly has ST Logistics leveraged technology to stay ahead of the curve?
Ken, as you said, technology has played a critical role in modern logistics, really driving efficiency, enabling real-time tracking, automation, predictive analytics, and so on. And you know, right, logistics is not a sexy industry. And with the aging population in Singapore, it is very hard to find people keen to work in this industry. Technology in particular, automation, and the digital transformation has enabled us to face these challenges and attract and retain young people in the industry. So now in ST Logistics, technology is infused into everything that we do. Allow me to share a few examples of how technology implementation has helped both internally for ourselves and for our customers. The first example, in the warehouse. We have automation such as Lenovo's four-way shuttle system, automated MHEs, unmanned forklifts, that has reduced labor, raised productivity, and has streamlined processes. Second, we have created what is called e-medical cabinets. It's basically a smart cabinet outside accident emergency departments that we put into all hospitals so that the paramedics can come take essential medical items for the ambulance duties. That really uses AI and sensors to track supplies in real time. So paramedics can just go there, scan the cabinet, open, and take whatever they need and go. All done in seconds. They can now focus on saving lives. And the third example is the use of 24/7 AI-powered unmanned stores, which we have installed in the army camps, police units, and fire stations. These are unmanned stores streamline the collection and return of equipment without a need for a man in the loop. There is no need for stock pick, there is accountability. So that's how we use advancement in technology and innovation to redefine the future of logistics to empower both our frontline heroes, our customers, as well as our employees, and to stay ahead of the curve.
Well, this is amazing, Logan. I was in your warehouse just now. Well, I was amazed by the automation that ST Logistics has put into your operation and you know how seamless the operation is. So this is truly amazing. CAT can also be used to create meaningful impact for a nation, as we have seen in Singapore, a country that is a global hub for innovation. And you know what? ST Logistics plays a key role in that ecosystem. Logan, in your view, what is the dynamic between the public and the private sector when it comes to making technology work for greater good? And what are the things that other countries can learn from Singapore as an example?
So can ST Logistics plays a critical role as a national resilience firm, especially during crises such as pandemic or humanitarian disasters around the region. We are very focused on high assurance and high security requirements for our customers. And we move with the flow of the nation from defense to elections to healthcare and to crisis response. In Singapore, public-private partnership isn't just about working together. It's co-creation. The government sets the long-term vision and provides the support structures. The private sector then brings in technology, solutions, and empowerment. For example, you know, in Singapore, the government funds and guides national upskilling and reskilling in a big way. Private sector then must step up, use these resources, and act and future-proof their workforce. This is where I would say policy meets reality, turning vision and ideas into actionable results. For instance, take our in-house modular app that we created for the elections. It is a digital platform that streamlines the general election logistics and provides real-time updates from the ground. It wasn't off the shelf. It was purpose-built. So co-creation isn't just a concept for us. I think it's a responsibility to solve real problems with purpose and accountability. And that applies not just to Singapore, any other country, as you say.
I've been traveling around the world and serving a lot of customers. I think, you know, whenever I see, you know, whoever can bring the best outcome from technology is when a domain expert marry with technology expert, right? You cannot miss, you know, either of that. Right? So, I mean, I think that is exactly what you just shared with us. Well, I have to bring up an interesting tidbit I learned about you. I know you learned how to code yourself, although you're not a programmer by training. You spend late nights picking things up from your team. You learn, and you really walk the talk during XT Logistics digital transformation. Now, I also work in tech, so I know how difficult and how you know, steep the learning curve can be. So, I mean, the question for you is, how has this hands-on leadership philosophy shaped your career and the way that you lead the company?
So, Ken, I believe that leaders need to take the bull by the horns. You can't just talk about transformation from the boardroom. You have to embody the transformation. So, I asked our developers to teach me how to create an app. I spent, as you say, some late nights learning how to code. I'm not a programmer. But just to grasp the logic, the pain points, and the possibilities this can offer. And I wanted to understand what our teams were going through and what it really takes to create something from scratch. And all our senior leaders went through AI training. And by that, we are sending a very strong signal that no one is too old or too senior to learn. So to me, transformation is really a leadership responsibility. I have to walk the talk. Lead by example. And so it really starts with me.
I think what you just said is, you know, something that is going to be beneficial for a lot of our audiences, including my kids, right? So, and again, I think that mindset of continuous learning really, I would say, resonates with me. And it clearly plays a big role in fostering innovation in ST Logistics, I believe. From what I have seen, your team seems to be very enthusiastic to experiment, grow, and contribute meaningfully. Well, so Seth, can you share an initiative or a moment that you are personally very proud of, something that you know, truly reflect your culture of care and empowerment of ST Logistics as a CEO of the company?
So I am very proud of how all our employees stepped up to support the nation during COVID-19. ST Logistics was tasked to acquire PPEs such as masks, high-risk gowns, and essential medical items for the entire nation. So COVID really brought up the significance of logistics to the national ecosystem, not just in Singapore, I think throughout the world. Logistics at the best is an act of care. We may not be seen, not in the spotlight, no headlines, but I can confidently say we will always be there when called upon.
Well, I think you and I just talked before we do the shooting, right? So while everyone is saying that, you know, AI is necessary, right? I cannot think of any company can run an excellent operation without AI. I would say there's another thing in addition to AI is logistics, right? You and I talked, I cannot find any company on the planet where you know, logistics is not in their operation. But as you said, I think logistics has been like a given for everyone, right? No one thinks about, you know, the real importance of logistics, but that change when COVID comes, right? This is exactly the example that you just shared. If today's discussion got you thinking, stay tuned. We'll be back with more conversation with leaders who are redefining business, technology, and what is next. Lenovo.